the women of the state, as well as for every individual person of the state, Ned Lamont should be our next senator. Thank you. And
the National Non-Political Action Committee is pleased to announce our endorsement for Democratic candidate Ned Lamont for the United States Senate. Choices for women. He certainly understands that reproductive justice includes full access for rape victims to emergency contraception. Yeah. The attack on Roe in South Dakota was predictable and a direct consequence of the confirmations of John Roberts and Samuel Alito to the Supreme Court, and the strategy to pack the courts with right-wing judges who are committed to overturning Roe is no secret. Ned Lamont recognizes that civil rights for all encompasses the right of everyone to marry the person that they love, regardless of their gender. And we are confident we have found principled leadership in Ned Lamont and are proud to endorse his candidacy for the U.S. Senate. And with that, I'm
This endorsement means an awful lot to me. You know, Melody, I'm, you know, on board 100% with the NOW agenda. You're going to have a senator that you can call your own come January. I'd also like to say I'm particularly pleased to have this endorsement. It's the first national endorsement I've gotten.
All right.
Some classes up at Bridgeport High School. It's a course called How to Start Your Own Business. And frankly, at Harding High School, by far the most popular course amongst all the girls at the high school is the nursing module. You know, they tell me it's guaranteed $18 an hour when I graduate, and there's nothing better than that. Look, and I appreciate that, but in our class, we're also giving people an opportunity to dream. They play role models. They're director of marketing for a company one day. We bring in folks, the men and women who have started up companies from within the Bridgeport community. And I just think it gives the kids an opportunity to dream. And I think one of the great things about America in this day and age is anybody can do anything if they have the confidence and the will and the heart to go for it. And that's one of the things we try and do in this little class of ours. We could do that in this country. We could do it if we put our mind to it. You know, what I hate about this war, it's not just an incursion into a Middle Eastern country. It says an awful lot about what type of a country we are, what our priorities are, and where we want to go forward. And I think we could do an awful lot better than we're doing right now. And it just seems to me we have a Bush administration that is walking away from some of the fundamental obligations that our country has had to its folks for a long time, be it Medicare and Medicaid and Social Security. Cuts in these programs particularly disadvantage women. They're the first ones hit by cuts in programs like that. But at the same time, they're intruding into our private lives every day in ways the Founding Fathers never, never, never anticipated. It can be one of the first things that got me inspired was the Terri Schiavo case. You remember that case, don't you? I mean, my gosh, George Bush flying back from one of his endless vacations in Crawford, Texas, Tom DeLay, we've got to intervene in a case like this, the decision that belongs with the family, decisions like this, life and death decisions that families are making every day around the country, the last place you want the federal government intruding. And Tom DeLay said, of course, the federal government's got to be there. And Joe Lieberman said, yes, we want the federal government here when it comes to questions of life and death. I think that was wrong. Creationism in the classroom, be it stem cell research, be it emergency contraception for women. Look, the FDA is a scientific group. They looked at this, they found the safety of it, the scientists opined on it, and then the politicians stepped in. And the politicians said, we're going to step all over the scientists again, and we're not going to let emergency contraception be available over the counter. And I look at the callousness of the response when it comes to rape victims going to any hospital. We talk about universal health care in this country. We ought to have a basic level of health care that's available for everybody. And my God, how can you deny that basic level of health care to rape victims when they go to a hospital? They don't choose the hospital they're going to. That's a basic right that ought to be there. And you're going to have a senator who's going to stand up and say, you're going to be required to provide emergency contraception to every rape victim, wherever they may go. We're going to make this available over the counter. We're not going to put women into this impossible situation where they're forced to make these terrible choices. We'll reduce the number of unwanted pregnancies, and there'll be less need for abortion. And with universal health care for everybody, including prenatal and postnatal, you know, that to me is a real pro-life agenda. That's what we're standing for as Democrats, and that's what we're going to carry. Women, the way we treat our girls says so much about what we are as a country, and the way we go out and fight around the world for those same values, I think says a lot about who we are to the rest of the world. And I think we've got to capture what makes America America again, and that's why I'm in this race. And thank you so much for your support. I needed it.
This is great.
It didn't take more than a short ride to get to another hospital. Wasn't that the most callous thing ever?
This is great.
50-minute walk, 27-minute walk.
You don't exactly get cabs in the middle of Connecticut.
In the middle of the night.
This is not Manhattan. It's been away too long.
So where was Connecticut?
Compared to other states.
I think that's why this is just such a graphic that illustrates the absurdity and of
No, this was a blast. They were up there.
Yeah, they were out there.
I'll tell you one thing. It has galvanized people on this, you know, Camp Danger. People know that issue.
And you know,
it just was a shining line for folks.
And our organization has never, ever turned back from a fight. We're fearless and bold, and that's why we are looking at Ned Lamont to lead us in the U.S. Senate in the fight for women's equality in the United States.
Yeah, as I noted, we've got all sorts of quiet support. Everybody says, I'm with you privately. You know, we're watching closely. The national organization won't let us get involved. And that's what I love about now. They've never been afraid of a fight when they know they're right. They're working hard on issues. And that's why you want them defending you every step of the way. And that's why I'm awful happy to have them as part of our team.
Into those races.
Hey, you know, you're good. Have you ever thought of running for office? I think you could really gin things up here a little bit.
She had a competitive race to get where she is now, I heard.
Exactly. Yeah, that was hot. Yeah, a feminist competition is something else, too.
Is NOW planning any work in terms of NOW helping to support the campaign and using your grassroots?
Sure, we would love to. Anything, once we have given our endorsement, it means our grassroots, it means our membership, it means our commitment, our energy, and our dedication. So that all, it comes as a package.
That's great. Thank you very much.
Package, thanks.
Thanks. Yeah, actually, maybe I'll...
Melody Dernack, Vice President, Action for the National Organization for Women.
Great, thanks. Here, and here's Melody's
there's my,
card
like my number
for you there, Bob, and I'll bring it with me.
Okay, I'm Rosemary Dempsey. I am lucky enough to be the President of Connecticut NOW, and I am delighted that we had this event today. I'm delighted that our National NOW PAC has endorsed it. That's why we're here today, and thanks for coming, and log on.
Thank you very much.
Okay.